Hey, welcome to Fix Fedak, and today I have some new flashlights from Olight to talk to you about. They are these two, which is the S10R 3 baton and the S30R 3 baton, which are in line with the other baton flashlights. If you remember my review of the S1A baton and the S2A baton, which are very nice flashlights, they take a single AA battery in this one, and the S2A takes two AA batteries. These are not rechargeable flashlights, but they are very useful. And get out my little cheat sheet first so I can remember how many lumens they are. We have the S1A is 600 lumens, the S2A is 550 lumens. Then the next one up that we have, these sets are rechargeable. They have the magnetic base, which works with the magnetic USB charger here that we have. Plugs into there, and it plugs into that one. And it'll also work with these newer ones, the S10R3 and the S30R3, which is really cool. This USB charger is perfect for backpacking and using with your whatever backpacking charging device you're going to be using, such as the Pocket Juice 20,000 amp hour kit that I'm going to be bringing, or 20,000 milliamp hour battery pack that I'm going to be taking with me on the Appalachian Trail. I could plug this into that, and then plug any one of these four flashlights into it to charge, so it's perfect. Not that I'm taking all four of these on the AT, it just works with it. So the S1R, this one, is a 900 lumen flashlight, and it runs on the RCR123 battery. The S2R is also a rechargeable flashlight, and the S2R is an 1120 lumen flashlight. So these two are really, really bright, 900 lumens and 1120 lumens. So these two are the brightest flashlights that I have currently right now, and they're really, really nice. And in fact, they're the two flashlights that my wife and I use the most. I use the little one daily, and my wife uses this one daily. And now the new ones that I just got, here's the packages for them. And the new ones that I just got, the S10R3 is a 600 lumen, so it uses the same battery as this one does, the S1R. The S1R is 900 lumens, if you recall, and the S10R, the new one, is only 600 lumens, so it's a little bit less in brightness, but it has some other features that we'll talk about here shortly. And the S30R3 baton is 1050 lumens, where the S2R baton is 1120. So the S30R baton is also not as bright as its cousins here. And but aside from that, there are some advantages to the new lights. Let me put away my cheat sheet now that I don't need it anymore. Okay. It's cold and snowy out here, but we'll get through it. All four of them use the same charger, but these new ones, the S10R and the S30R, come with a docking station version. So they work with this version, but they come with this version here, which is pretty nice. They sit like that, and you can plug it into any USB, charge off. There you go. Both of these flashlights, each one of these flashlights comes with a docking station, a charging cord, and a lanyard. And of course, your other flashlights that have the rechargeable magnetic base will also work on the docking station as well. And one of the cool things about the docking station is it has the suction cups on it. So if you have a flat surface, a smooth surface, glass or something like that, or a flat slick linoleum surface or something, it will suction cup to that. Currently I'm using a frozen piece of plywood. Okay. So with that said, these bezels on both of these flashlights, they have a glow-in-the-dark ring, which I didn't notice until after I started using it and making the other clip that I showed you where we were using it in the dark. You'll see it later. Just underneath this blue bezel, you'll see a glow-in-the-dark ring later when we turn the flashlights on in the dark, which is really cool. Same with this one here. The bezels, these flashlights here, are a little bit wider in diameter than these are, so they're a little bit thicker. And there's a reason for that later. There are attachments that you can get, at least for this one. And let's see. The LEDs, the light bulbs in these things, are different. So they upgraded the light bulbs. So the new ones, the S10R and the S30R, have a new light bulb in there, which is different compared to the other one. This one here is the new one, the S10R, and this one here is the S1R, S1R, S10R. So you can see the light bulb differences in there, hopefully. So the S10R has a new light bulb, the S30R has a new light bulb, which lasts longer, and let's see, they are all good for drop tests down to a 2 meter drop test. They are all good for 1.5 meter drop test and a 2 meter dunk test for water for drowning. And we'll start with the S10R3. Like we said, it's a 600 lumen and IPX8 or 2 meter drowning. It has 118 meter sight distance. Again, it comes with the RCR123A battery, rechargeable, docking station, and a lanyard with a lanyard pin to get it looped in there. It has this 5 settings. Its lowest setting is 0.5 lumens, which will last for 15 days, which is the moon. Its low setting is 12 lumens, which will last for 33 hours. Its medium setting is 120 lumens, which will last for 160 minutes. And then it has high of 300 lumens for 60 minutes. And then what I call a turbo mode of 600 lumens for 1.5 minutes. Now, it doesn't mean that it'll kill the flashlight, the battery will die after 1.5 minutes. It just means that the flashlight gets hot, and what it'll do is it'll shine for 600 lumens for 1.5 minutes, then it drops down to 300 lumens while it cools. Once the flashlight is cooled off, you can go back up to 600 lumens and be good to go. So it has, let's see, bezel diameter is 23 millimeters and it weighs 58 grams or 2 ounces, including the battery. So with the battery, it weighs 2 ounces or 58 grams. Now the reason why the 23 millimeter bezel is important with the S10R Baton 3, or at least important to me, is because if you get the FM10 light filters, which come in red, green, or blue, and they range about $9 to $10 on Amazon or eBay, you can change the color. By, it's basically a silicone or rubber or silicone slip that you can put over this that has a red, green, or blue filter to change the color of the light for the end of the flashlight. But it only works with bezels that are 23 millimeters, which the S10R3 Baton flashlight has. It will not work with the S1R or the S1A because they're too narrow. And I really, really like that because the the Olight flashlight series doesn't have the option of different color LED lights. You just have to put on a filter on them to change the color. So if you're backpacking and you come into a shelter on the Appalachian Trail, you got other backpackers there at night, you don't want to blind them. And you don't want to ruin your night vision with white lights. So red is great for that. If you're doing first aid or whatever, you can't see blood under a red light. So you want blue for that. And then green is great if you're using night vision optics and stuff. And then it also has a TW10, which is a traffic wand, which is an orange traffic wand or a white traffic wand. They range anywhere from $3 to $5 on Amazon and eBay, which also attached to this. And what that does is basically turn it into a candle or a lantern, which really brightens up the area. And basically like turning on a lantern in your room or in the area, your little campsite area, or your tent or whatever. So it works out really, really well. So this is basically the flashlight that currently, as of now, I'm going to be leaving April 3rd, 2017 to go on a through hike, which is going to last approximately 5 to 6 months. So from April through September, I'll be on a through hike on the Appalachian Trail. And out of all the flashlights that I own, this will be the one currently that I'm taking with me because of the fact that I could put a blue filter on it and I could take the orange traffic cone on it. So it gives me lots of options, and it's rechargeable with a magnetic base and a clip on there, and I can use it with this rechargeable USB plug here, or I could take this one, but I'm going to leave this one at home and I'm going to take this one here with me. So later on in this video series, the next couple of video clips, you'll see these two flashlights, the new ones, the S10R3 and the S30R3. We'll go through and we're going to do take them in the dark and turn the lights on to go through the cycles. It's a real foggy night, but you'll get to see exactly how the light beam works and the cone of light. But we are unable to test the actual distance because it's been really foggy the last several nights, and it's supposed to be foggy again tonight. So you can't see exactly how far the light shines, but you'll get to see how bright it is, and because of the fog, you'll get to see the shape of the light and the beam and everything. So it's really, really cool, especially when I put it on strobe and for both of those lights. Now the S30R3 has a sight distance on the package, according to the package, of 188 meters. And it's 1,050 lumens for its maximum. So let's go over the different settings for that. So its minimum moon setting is 0.5 lumens for 100 days. Its low is 12 lumens for 130 hours. Its medium is 120 lumens for 15 hours. Its high is 500 lumens for 210 minutes. Then it goes into the turbo mode, which is 1,050 lumens for 2 minutes. And then when it heats up, it drops down to 500 lumens for 200 minutes. So there you have it. And then it has the same impact rating of 1.5 meter drop, 2 meter waterproof. It has a bezel diameter of 25 millimeters, so the filters and the traffic wand cones that I was talking about for the S10 won't fit on this, but it's still pretty good light. And it has a length of 114 millimeters, and let's see, I don't think I gave you the length of this one. The S10 is 68.5 millimeters long. So, alrighty. Now we'll just go ahead and cut this off here, and we'll shoot to the nighttime video where you get to see the lights. After that, we have back to a daytime video where we drop the lights and on the ground and the ice and the rocks, and you get to see the drop test. We do not do a water dunking test because it's like 20 degrees out here and it's very, very cold, and I don't want to get frostbite or hypothermic by putting my hands in ice cold water. So for for safety reasons, we won't be doing, for safety reasons of my human body, I don't want to do a dunk test. But we have done dunk tests on these other four flashlights, which are rated for a 2-meter dunk in the water, and they've passed with flying colors, no issues. So because this is in the same line of the Baton flashlight series, I can vouch for it that these will be just as dunkable and water resistant or waterproof up to 2 meters as the rest of these flashlights are. So thanks for watching and stay tuned for the rest of the review. Alright, and we're outside now. It's actually a warm night for a change. I'm actually in shorts. But it's a real foggy night and it's pitch black out here, so you're not going to see anything until I turn on a flashlight. But can you see the glow rings?
I thought I saw them there. Yeah. Okay. When you get really close. That's one of them, okay. Anyways.
Don't move the camera. Okay. One of the things that the flashlights have on it is a ring of glowing, or glow ring around the bezel of the flashlight so that you can find the flashlight. That's pretty awesome. Didn't realize that until we got outside into the dark and found it. Both the S10R and the S30R Batons have that. I should say the S10R3 and the S30R3 have that. So when you have the flashlight on and you're using it, it charges that glow ring. In the daylight, the glow ring looks blue, and then when you're in the dark, it glows green. So I'm going to start with the S30R, well, let's start with the S10R3, because it's the only 600 lumens. And we'll shine it, let's shine it this way.
Okay.
Okay, I'm going to turn it on its lowest setting, and then we'll work up to its brightest setting. Its lowest setting is 0.5 lumens, and its brightest setting is 600 lumens. Then it does, it goes from 600 lumens to 300 lumens to 120 lumens to 0.5 lumens. But we're going to start out at the lowest. So to do it, you press and hold, and it goes to moonlight.
I don't think it really caught much. There we go.
Okay, yeah, there's moonlight.
We have snow. It was like 0 degrees a couple days ago, and then it warmed, dumped a bunch of snow, and then it warmed up to 40. So you're going to see a mix of everything.
Next one, and then the 600.
Oh, the fog looks cool.
So there's the 0.5 lumens, which in the snow and the fog, it looks a lot brighter than normally does.
Yeah.
You can see that?
Yeah, I can actually, okay. You can see it, plus I can see where your hand is.
Yeah, 0.5 lumens in the snow, reflecting in the snow, is a lot brighter than it does when we did them in the summertime on gravel without snow.
Yeah.
And then that's 120 lumens. And that's 300 lumens. And that's the 600 lumens. And that's pretty cool.
I wish we could get fog every time we do flashlight reviews, because I have this looks like Star Wars.
Shine it over to that blue sign over there. Well, it's not gonna. Normally we'd be lighting up the sign down at the end of the about 300 feet away, about 100 yards away. This does 118 meters is the maximum distance, but it's real foggy tonight, so it's not going to go that far because it's a thick fog.
It's got this amazing plume.
Yeah,
of
it looks
light.
Like I'm smoking.
Yeah, that's cool too. Any moisture in the air is quickly condensing.
So I'm going to turn this off and we're going to look at the glow ring again.
Cool. Oh yeah, that's super bright now.
Yeah, that's awesome.
Like it's crisply focusing. It's that bright.
And now this flashlight, you can purchase the FM10. Green filter, red filter, or blue filter to go over it to give you a blue light or red light or green light. And you can also purchase an orange traffic wand called the TW10 or a white traffic wand called the TW10. The traffic wands are $3 and some change, all the way up to $5 depending on where you get it from. And the filters, the red, blue, or green filters, are on average around $9 to $10. And this is going to be, as of current standing, the S10R3 is going to be my flashlight that I take backpacking on my through hike on the Appalachian Trail starting in April through September of next year, because of the fact that A, it's rechargeable, B, it has the glow ring on here, And C, it has the light filter that I can attach to it, because I'm going to be purchasing the blue light, the blue filter that goes on it, and the orange nose cone to go on it. And then that way I'll be able to use the orange nose cone as a camp lantern, and the blue filter as a filter light to keep the to keep me from blinding people in the shelter. And so this will be the S10. Let me turn on this other light.
If I got the camera protected from the dribbles.
Yeah, you're good. Okay. So this will be the flashlight that I take with me on my backpacking trip on the Appalachian Trail.
It's compact.
Because it, and also it's D is really small and lightweight. So okay, so this is the S30R3, and it has the glow ring as well, which is just freaking awesome. I like that a lot.
There it is. Found it.
Okay. And it has the, it starts out at 0.5 lumens. Let me find the button. I always lose the button on, there it is. I always lose the button on the Olight flashlights, which is the only downside.
Yeah, I have to make sure I have.
Press and hold the button for 2 seconds.
There we go.
And you get the 0.5 lumen. Then the next one is 120 lumens. And then from here on, I don't remember all of the lumens for each setting, but the final lumens is 1050. So there's the next one. And then there's the next one. And then you press it, double press, and it gives you to the maximum, or which is 1050. And again, with the with all the fog,
you can see the light pattern. That's kind of cool. Yeah. How it's got the dense inner side, and then it spreads out. I think this one spreads out a little more than the other one did.
Yeah, this has got a real. You can see wide. The cone of it really well. Let's look over here in the woods. There you go. You see the cone shape of how it spreads out in the fog. It's real nice.
Point it upwards. We are going quite some distance up with that.
Yeah, it goes. It's got a very far spread on it.
This is the kind of thing you'd put like a shaped filter or shadow thing on, and we could signal for superheroes with.
And then if you triple click either the S30R3 or the S10R3, you get the 10 hertz
Ow.
Strobe. And now we got two strobes going on. They're both at 600 lumens, 10 hertz for the S10R.
It's interesting.
And 1050 lumens, 10 hertz for the S30R3.
One looks a little bit more of a
Don't
bluish.
Cross the beams.
I don't think that matters with these. I haven't seen any large, giant dessert things to be putting on s'mores running around lately. Can't see all of you at once. I'm too close. There. Now they kind of look like weird rocket blasters at that. Like hold them sideways and make them go whoosh.
Like that?
The fog. No. Like point them so that they're going the same direction and then just kind of move slowly. Like they're rocket engines propelling things out the back end or comets or something. Okay, if I pan, oh, never mind. He turned them on.
Yeah. There's the rings again.
Those seem to dim quickly, but mm-hmm. then they dim to a certain level and they just maintain at that level somehow.
Now they also have the timer on them mm-hmm. so that you do a, when you got it on the light that you want, and then you do a, I haven't remembered the press code for it yet, but you got a press code for it, and it sets it on a timer for a couple of minutes, and then it'll turn itself off when the timer runs out. So that if you need to set it up somewhere to in your car as you walk to the house or whatever.
Or if you think you'll fall asleep while you're reading a book or something.
Fall asleep while you're reading a book or whatever. It will turn itself off for doing that. So. Really awesome flashlights, and you can find more information in the more info box below the video for links and stuff to where you can get them. So thanks for watching. All right, now that it's daylight, let me show you the S30R outside. There's my frozen oak stump that we normally drop. Oak or maple, I can't recall. And over here is the ice and gravel. We're going to go ahead and do the drop test. I'm not going to do the water dunk test out here because it's like 20 degrees and I don't want to freeze my hand off. So, just like all the Olight flashlights, they are waterproof down to like 2 meters. So, and I've never had one fail in a waterproof test. So take my word for it, or take Olight's word for it. They are very good for what they are rated for the water. And I've drained my water barrel already for winter, so I don't really have a water barrel to test them in. But we're gonna drop the S30R first, and then we will drop to the drop test for the S10R and show you that they still work good. Let's get this turned on here. Cycle through. So you see that it cycles through just fine. There's a good drop there. Let's get another drop. Alright. Let's drop it on some rocks. Okay, brush the snow off. Check it out. Seems to be alright, I don't notice anything wrong with it. And cycle through those lights. Alright. The glow ring seems to be intact and it seems to work just good. Alright, now let's try the smaller little brother, S10R3. Cycle it through. Got it on there. Got the bright one. Drop it on there. Drop it on again. Drop it on some rocks. Let's do another drop there. Alright, throw it over there. Alright, brush it off. Let me see here. I don't see any cracks or scrapes or anything. Oh, we got a little scratch. Well, looks like a little scratch right there. Must have hit a rock just right. But other than that, doesn't seem to be anything wrong with it at all. Let's see if it goes through its lights. Flashes. Everything seems to work good, and its glow ring and everything seems to be attached. Its glow ring seems to be intact, what I meant to say, and it works pretty good. So, again, two very good flashlights. I will be ordering the orange and yellow nose cones for this, and I'm leaning towards the blue filter for this flashlight. That way, I like blue because it makes blood show up black, and it's not very easily seen from a long distance. It's easy on the eyes, and everybody runs around with red, and with a red filter you can't see blood. And so if you're trying to do first aid at night and stuff, red filters don't work very well. Red and blue are good for night vision, not destroying your night vision. So I can use a blue filter and not destroy my night vision, and still be able to do first aid stuff and read maps and everything. So I think that's why I'm going to go with the blue. Green doesn't, it provides light for your night vision equipment, but you can't see it when you're using night vision equipment and stuff. So I think I'm going to go with the blue lens. And alrighty, so there you have it. Hope you enjoyed the review. Any questions or comments, feel free to leave them down below and I'll answer them the best I can, or refer you to the Olight website, which that link will be down below as well. So thanks for watching.